Alright, you awesome people. I hope you had a nice coffee. Here we are to understand something exciting about PowerShell. So, according to you, what is the most important thing for you to write a script which does something for you? I know that wasn't tough for you people. Of course, it is commands which we need to do anything and everything, right? Okay, next question. Is it possible for you to remember more than 500 different commands available in PowerShell? I'm assuming you answered in no. I think you are right. It's very, very difficult. You don't have to worry at all when you have PowerShell's git command as a savior. This command lists down each and every command available by default in our PowerShell. That sounds good, right? If I have all the commands, and if I am able to find the right command for my requirement, I think that solves at least 25% of the problem, right? Okay, let's explore this command then. Go to IIC, type git-command and execute it. You get this large list as output which contains all the commands. Okay, that sounds really good. But it is a big list, right? How do I find the command for my requirement? That is no big deal. Just go to the command and pass a value to the parameter name. Let's do it. Let's say I'm gonna do something with computer services. So write -name in quotes service. We are writing these wildcard characters because I am looking for all the commands which contain service as a keyword. Cool, I got this list of commands which has service in its name. Now I can get the exact command as per my requirement from this sorted output. Another example, let's say I am working on different processes on my computer. No worries, just replace word service with process and execute. And we get all available commands for process now. How cool is that? I'm sure you are already impressed with PowerShell, but believe me, there is much more to come. Now I have got the command, but what to do with it? I don't know how to use it. To teach us how to use any command, we have git-help. Let's see how to use it. In order to get help for any particular command, we just need to type git-help and let's say we need help for git service and execute it. And you see, we have got the help description for this command, which I can read and understand how this command functions. Fine, but I'm not satisfied without examples. Okay, my lord, you have parameter to access the complete help for a command. Let's use it. And you see, now we have obtained examples and other details of this command as well. Okay, that is impressive. But I don't like scrolling in this console to read. I need a separate space to read this help content. Hey, why don't you go online? Just put online instead of full and here you go. It will take you to the help section for the command on Microsoft website. Fine, but what if I don't have internet connectivity? Quite possible. So what you do is you can use show window as a parameter. That should definitely help you. You see, it has opened entirely new window to help you with this command. Here you can select whatever you want to see and also you can search for the thing you are looking for. I don't think anyone will have any excuses now, and that makes me happy to conclude this video as well. Now it is your turn to make me happy by trying few command from git command list yourself and try to get into their help description and develop some understanding about them. I'll see you in the next video with another cool feature of PowerShell. Take care. Thank you.